No. Damn it!
What are you gonna do if I broke into your house?
It's not gonna take as long this time. I promise.
My trauma doesn't allow me to watch Alice in Wonderland because when that cat's like, we're all mad here, I'm just like, at me?
Here we go.
Are you serious?
Mother Miranda, I'm
I must protect.
Quiet now, child.
I remember when they first invented big booty bitches. I always loved them.
Don't fuck with me, Mark. I have the power of God and anime on my side.
Hey, can you hear me?
Child's father.
Look at her eyeballs.
You mean Rusty? Where's Rose?
The fact that you just stood there recording it and didn't offer a helping hand.
Oh, I'm sorry. Let me just.
Is she okay?
It's chill, but it's a block like a lost cloud.
Hey, this is why there's never more than like 3 Black Power Rangers in the show, bro. Cause y'all be doing too much, bro. Y'all showing your powers too much, bro.
I hate my ex. Hope you fall down the stairs and you break your neck. Get fired from your job, end up homeless. Hope your new relationship ends over a text. I hope you step on a tack and you stub your toe. Hope your son smokes crack and your daughter's a hoe. Hope your teeth turn black and your.
I don't want peace. I want problems, always!
So you get a magnificent pair of bananas.
Oh, great heavens!
Coming at you guys with the greatest food combination of all time. Oreos and sour cream.
Say it with me now. That's that.
Yes, hello. I was supposed to get a delivery of love and affection. Where the fuck is it?
Oh, honey, I am so sorry you have to hear this from me, but he's not into your personality. He's into you because you're a
Fucking hell. So I've had a lot of comments telling me, oh no, you should not be calling her honey. That's incredibly disrespectful. You're being rude. You're talking down to her. And all I really have to say to that is, honey, it's okay. Like, that's just how I talk. You're fine.
Excuse me. FYP, which one of you hating ass, bad breath, no car, low rent, box TV, no cable, scratch DVD, playing house arrest, sink bathing, black and mild, smoking tuna pussy, deadbeat, county rat, plasma center, going sterling silver, wearing shitty mark draws, miserable ass track, phone carrying, corner store fit, motherfucking no control with they kids, Reggie smoking, motherfucking mama couch sleeping, dishwashing liquid for bubbles, EBT card in review, motherfucking nail biting, no license, Reebok classic, wearing dusty single cigarette buying ass bitches, went and reported my motherfucking account because you got me banned.
Fuck your life. Bing bong.
If you see these dogs in your front yard, just know upstairs I'm going hard. Bing bong.
What do you want to tell Joe Biden right now?
What's up, baby? Take me out to dinner.
Hey yo, Ariana Grande, what's up, mama? I'll come to Coney Island.
Not y'all coming for yourselves. Y'all are going so hard on your own race.
in these comments. I need there to be several seats taken. And if you can't find a seat, I will provide one for you because this is getting out of pocket.
No.
Pass the cranberry sauce. We're having mashed potatoes. Ooh, the turkey looks great. Thank you for loving me.
Len.
Thank you for being there.
Please.
Thank you for loving me.
Oh, God.
Everyone's thank...
In there! Smile, be like...
Can't help it, I want you. I can't stop.
Shout to the horn, and you're to blame. Darling, you give love off a bit of me.
Women are here doing all the work, and men be like, call me daddy. Mire, cabrón. She doing all the work, you call her daddy. You drink your milk, and you go play Fortnite. Pendejo. Like, women are never satisfied. Really? I wonder why.
Claire Wolf.
Oh, what's up, man? Hey.
Oh, you're next.
Was recording the fire next door when the 4-year-old I nanny said this.
That's a lot of fire.
It's a good time to say, holy smoke.
Your soul is mine.
This is good. Hello there.
General Kenobi.
Elijah, get over here and pick up these socks. Hey! Liam, pick up the socks. Pick up the socks. I know you didn't put them on the floor. Get over here and pick up these damn socks. Fat boy. Hey! Come here! Liam! Elijah, come pick up these socks that y'all dumped over the floor. Yeah. Elijah! Yeah. Elijah, come pick up these socks now. Yeah. Come pick up these socks, you fat motherfucker.
There's two kangaroos.
How are you whistling in your
back?
A couple of kangaroos enjoying
a sunny day. Come on, okay. Do not demand a big girl to sit on your face, unless you are willing to go to Valhalla, okay?
Glory, glory, what a hell of a way to die!
You're wasting time on the stage, and we're gonna lose the subject.
Acorns.
However you dress, wherever you go.
Whoever threw that...
What's your name?
Janara.
And you... Yo, black people, step it up, yo. Step it up. First of all, you need to give that so damn black shirt to that woman right there, okay? Janana? Janana. That's a white woman named Janana. Black people that are a little bit older, have you ever heard of a white person named Janana? Bro, what is happening right now? What's your name? Volgana? Yo, Game of Thrones is over, white people. Y'all need to really just relax. Give it up. It ain't coming back.
Oh, you guys are Russian. Bosnian.
I don't know what shit looks like in Bosnia, but I imagine it's a lot like King's Landing.
Don't they film it over there? How far is Croatia from there? It's right next to it, right? It's Bosnia, Serbia, Montenegro. I don't even feel comfortable saying that one. Montenegro, that sounds like you riding black dick. You're pissed off ass parents. She got a black boy. I take you from Montenegro all the way to St. Louis, and now you're Montenegro? What just happened? This is not our family dream. We sold all three dragons to come here.
Right here. Right here. Bitch! Cushion sausage.
What? So there's actually a reason why you think the left side of your face looks better than the right.
Go on.
Man, I would love to play D&D, but I just don't know any groups that play.
I do. I'm in a group. You can join and play with us.
Oh, but that wouldn't be right. I haven't even met the Dungeon Master yet. I feel like I was intruding.
No worries. I'm the Dungeon Master, and I say that you can play.
I don't feel comfortable starting in the middle of a campaign.
Well, it just so happens that we're starting a brand new campaign tonight, so you'll be right on track with the rest of us.
Oh, well, I don't know how to play.
We love newcomers and teaching them how to play. But your group is probably full already. I don't want to take up any more space. We just had somebody leave the group, so we're actively attempting to fill one space. We have a very busy lifestyle, and I'm not available all that much. We only meet once a month and have to come to a consensus on which day that is.
But I don't have any dice.
Oh, I think you'll find that's not an issue.
But I'll make so many mistakes.
I know. That's part of the fun.
Oh, didn't I tell you to take out the trap? Baby's 20 minutes away. What are you doing? What are you doing?
One of these days you're gonna stop rotating and I'm gonna be fucking free. Hold on. How long you got? Probably got a little, maybe like a couple million years on me left, you know? Ah, you don't have to wait then. Motherfucker. What you want? Dada? Whoa, calm down.
Okay, so I'm 20 years old and I've never met anybody else that's able to do this. It's kind of hard to explain, so I'm just going to show you. Okay. So basically, look at my cat socks. Pretty cool. But
it's not like I'm offending anybody, all right? I'm just simply saying I come out here to see you prepping the chicken, and this is the flavors? Salt, pepper, and onion powder. I'm not going to eat it. There's no flavor in this house. I asked for hot sauce and all you got me was ketchup. I can't ever go to Flavor Town. I can't enjoy my dinner. I'm done. Stop the films. Seriously. I'm not eating chicken with salt and pepper on it. So, thanks anyway.
Sometimes I forget I'm a lesbian. And I don't mean like, oh my god, where did I put it? Like some sort of panisial amnesia or something. I forget that it's out of the norm or whatever. Because I'll spend the weekend, like, watching baking shows with my wife and judging bakers a little too harshly for my qualifications. But then I'll finally leave the house and, like, go to the store and I'll see a straight couple and be like, oh my god, honey, we're sinning. I forgot. Just, oh my god, this whole time. It's like when you leave your data on, even though you've been home all day, you've just been racking up sins, you know? Even though I've been in Wi-Fi. That's how they get you, you know? Jesus and AT&T and...
If a black person ever calls you cracker, just let them say it. You can say things they can't say either, like, thanks for the warning, officer.
Are there any elder millennials out there that also think about the fact that there was a pivotal moment in all of our lives where our parents were, like, conditioned to be terrified that all of us were going to end up going to raves? Like, if you're a dinosaur millennial, it was like, it's 12 a.m. Do you know where your kids are? Us, it was like, it's 5 a.m. Do you know if your kids' pupils are dilated? But then they would show us what this place looked like and on the news and in school, they were like, don't ever go to this place. You're like, why not? It looks like so much fun with the dancing and the lights and the... Why would you even show me what it looked like then? Their marketing strategy was we want you to resist being pressured by... But then they named the program DARE. What are you trying to tell me, Principal Nealon? You're daring me to do this because my sister said Nancy Reagan told her to just say no. That was Kerrigan. Millennial dinosaurs, they were like, don't get kidnapped. For us, it was don't do drugs. Kids now, it's like, please don't become a SoundCloud rapper.
Mary Jane.
What the fuck?
Call upon the gods.
Kids with severe spinal or scoliosis deformity may be placed in this weight and pulley system.
Don't you fucking do it. Don't you do it. You better not laugh. That boy's having issues. Don't you fucking do it. Don't laugh. Don't.
If I get this, you have to exist.
No.
I don't care how controversial it is. Raisins belong in mac and cheese.
You ain't got the sense. God give a billy goat.
Go sit your ass down. Go sit your ass down. No, damn, Raven's going up. Damn, mac and cheese.
To the side, yeah. Board.
Is this another corset video? Well. Father, apologies. Father, apologies. So sorry. I've stopped myself. We are good. It's not going to happen again. We are good. We are dirty.
As a Canadian, these are five things about America that absolutely terrify me. First, we got those sinks in your kitchen that can disintegrate your hand for literally no reason whatsoever. Why do you guys have these things, bud? Next is going to school. This will probably get taken down if I go too far into detail, so I'm gonna just leave it at that. But yeah, going to school in the States seems pretty scary, bud. Number three, we got Chicago, or as some people call it, Chirac. Last year, 774 people got murdered in Chicago here, which is more than the entirety of Canada combined. Even when we include Winnipeg. Number four is Black Friday. Every time I see this, it makes me think of Mufasa getting trampled by that herd of wildebeest. So not only is it terrifying, but it also makes me relive one of the most traumatic moments from my childhood. And lastly, we have Americans. Listen, I'll tell you right now, as a Canadian, there's been multiple times when I've had to defend myself from gooseuses and moosuses, but I would rather box an entire gaggle of gooseuses than have to fight a single American. You don't know when they're gonna pull out that burner and shoot you, bud.
We have no idea who this Adolf is you're talking about. And now you're just a common murderer.
Okay, wait, this reminds me of a tweet I really love. You kill baby Hitler and his memory fades from your consciousness. You don't remember why you did it, but you never forget murdering that baby.
I no longer go through depressive episodes. I just go through seasons of depression. For example, I'm on season 8, episode 5.
Fucking felt that.
Women are scary because...
Oh my god, hear me out. Hear me out. You go for the crotch and his Adam's apple.
Why is it spicy?
I love it!
This is your reminder that the bar for men is on the fucking floor. Me and my buddy were grabbing some drinks and we got hit on purely because they heard us talking about consent. The fact that I could be completely shitty as a person, but that's all it takes because it's never respected.
I just found out that owls can sit down with their legs crossed.